Dr. Moore. He asked the question, why are we doing this? It's real easy. It's money and politics. We ran a bill that said, when you go to Rocky Flats, here's what it will say, and it will warn you of the dangers of plutonium. Have you ever picked up a jar of honey at Safeway? Look at a jar of honey. It says, warning. Do not feed two infants under 1 year of age. What's the relationship between honey and plutonium? Which is the most dangerous to you? Of course you know that. Will you willingly let your kids go out there not knowing? Lance Armstrong was here, cancer survivor. How many of us are cancer survivors of you? Yet, we will say a pristine wilderness area. Go on a picnic out there. That's what's happening, and you tried to put some words up that say, this could be a hazard to your health. Try putting that up and see how far you get. You're making it look like it's unsafe. Our property values may fall. We may not sell a house. Talk to the county commissioners and see why they don't want me to put a sign up, why they don't want Rocky Mountain Peace and Justice Center to be involved in language. Same. Here's what could happen to you.
That's right, Wes.
Talk to them and see what they have to say about that. They have told me. They've denied me access out there because I will sensationalize the issue. I'm telling you the truth. Ask them why. Ask the Department of Public Health and Safety why they have said, well, you know, we agree there should be signs. That's the very least. What should happen to Rocky Flats is that we should put 2 feet of cement over 6,000 acres and put someone on every corner praying 24 hours a day that it did not migrate. That's the ideal. But why cover it up? Why cover up the truth? Christina Iverson is very knowledgeable on this. You'll be speaking next. Thank you.